Over the last 10 years, we've really gained a much better understanding of what drives cancer. And what we've learned is it's fundamentally a genetic disease.
Traditionally, what investigators have done is they've looked at one gene and maybe a few mutations in one gene, and then another gene, and then another gene. So what we're trying to do is to create one assay that comprehensively looks at all that information at the same time.
TruSight Tumor 170 has primarily been developed to capture and identify all the relevant genetic aberrations that are important in cancer.
We had to work to optimize so that we could use the smallest amount of nucleic acid possible. You get maybe one or two sections of tumor tissue. We've really maximized the output from a small amount of input sample for this assay.
I really like the approach to the broader panel. The 170 looks at both DNA and RNA, which opens up some other opportunities to really look at the biology of the tumor.
The assays that could combine those two, or doing multiple assays to be able to actually have the merge of that data from both the DNA and the RNA together, we think will be incredibly critical.
The way we've optimized the assay is that you extract both RNA and DNA together from the same sample, and then there's one step that's unique for each, and after that, the workflow is completely identical. We can then combine those into a single sequencing reaction, and then we get that comprehensive assessment of all the different kinds of variants from the same sample.
In the old days, it used to be that it was trying to understand cancer from behind a veil. Now we're pulling away the veil and really just looking at what are the mechanisms that really drive the disease forward.
It's wonderful to me when I think of a next-gen platform where we can look at known markers and variants, but there's additional information that's in there.
So it's like a new type of microscope that we can really peer into the very fabric of those cells and the DNA and the framework.
It's going to take us to another level of understanding of what's happening with the genetics of cancer.
Putting those tools in the hands of people that are using it on a day-to-day basis, I think it's going to be amazing.